screen wash into the old bird. Screen wash into this. Coolant is looking good. Oh, checked. So we top this up. Are you ready? There we go. Let the screen wash. Coolant's fine. Engine oil's fine.
The old bird's doing all right.
Still life in the old bird jet. Still life in the old bird jet. Is that on? Is that on properly? Yeah, there we go. Done. Done. Still starts, 126 miles on the clock, the baby's got, still going strong. Just need to get this a good clean, take it to the clean car wash now, get it cleaned, and good as new again. Not bad for a 7-year-old car, 8-year-old car. At the car wash, getting the car wash now, so I just need to wait. In the queue, as you can see there, there's other cars before me. That means you've got to be patient, Billy. You've got to be patient. So yeah, all good. I'll see you when it's all clean. Still waiting. So guys, whilst we're waiting, what we can do and talk about briefly is what's on this vlog. So as I said before, or if you didn't see before, in fact, the video where my BMW 4 Series Grand Coupe was involved in a collision. So if you've seen the previous video where the A-Class Mercedes crashed into the back of my BMW whilst I was static at the garage, go back and have a look at it. The link's above. You can have a look at what happened. Anyway, they did get back to me. The bodywork shop got back to me, and it was classed as a write-off, which I'm absolutely gutted about, because obviously I did love my car. So yep, I've got a valuation for the car, waiting for the insurance company to pay out now. But unfortunately, yes, I've lost my BMW. So am I gonna buy a new car? That's the question. So at the moment, probably not. We've got this old girl, 126,000 miles on the clock. We've had it since brand new. It's had two services every year, so I'm just gonna get it washed now. I've just pumped the tires up. I've just topped up the screen wash. The antifreeze looks good. And this is actually my wife's car. It used to be both of our cars. It's her car now, but obviously I'm gonna go back to driving it. So we're not gonna buy a new car at the moment, because with me starting my new job and doing nights, it makes sense just to have one car for now. But in the next vlog, this vlog should I say, we're gonna go through equipment that you need when you start, excuse me, got hiccups today, when you start your HGV career. So that's what I wanna touch on today with regards to equipment, what you're gonna need when you get started, what I've actually purchased, or what I've brought before I start my new job, which is Sunday, can't wait. Sunday, I start nights on Sunday. I'm out with another driver to get started with, just to get my experience, my confidence up, and to make sure that obviously they're happy before they let me go on the road on my own. So if you've got any questions, don't forget to like, comment below this video if you've got any questions on that. Any sort of equipment you think I should have, in fact, any experienced drivers out there, anything you could recommend if you've just started driving before me. Am I missing something with regards to my equipment? Let me know. I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Speak to you soon. How the devil are we? Right, so car's washed finally, parked outside, managed to get it washed after that long queue of cars. So that's all sorted. So let's move on to the whole point of this vlog today. It's to basically go through the equipment that every HGV driver, or 7.5-ton driver,
whether you're an Arctic driver, class one, class two, this is the equipment that I personally think you're going to need, and that would help you during your driving career. Now, like I said before, if there's anything that I've missed, any experienced drivers or relatively new drivers that have started driving, or even maybe you've been driving for years and you think I could add to this list, comment below and give us your feedback, because that's really, really important, okay? This is just based on what I think, what I prepared myself for when I start my new HGV career. Okay, so happy days, let's get on with this. Got me tea, yep, green tea, ginger, lemon, and herbs, I think it is. Healthier version than coffee that I drink all the time. So trying to be a little bit more healthier, that's what I'm trying to do. When you start your HGV career, there are certain bits of equipment that either the company will provide you, depending on who you work for, or to make your life easier, to get the equipment yourself. If you've got the money, brilliant, go and get the equipment yourself. What makes your life, at the end of the day, they say, whatever makes your life easier, use. So this is what I've gone for. When I start my new job, I'm going to be doing curtain side work, okay? I have applied for container work, I've applied for flatbed work, I've applied for curtain side work. I've applied for a lot of work since I've passed my driving qualification. And it's class one that I want to go into. So I have been offered a role, as I mentioned in the previous video, and it's curtain side work. I'm doing general haulage. So, in fact, I think now's a great time to maybe share this news with you guys. I did say previously, I can't say or declare the company that I've actually been offered a full-time contract with. And I wasn't going to do that until I spoke to my general GM, my general manager, just to make sure he was happy with it, etc., etc. So, the company that I have been offered a full-time role with, a full-time position with, is, wait for it, is, ta-da, Downton's Haulage. Downton's, yes it is. So that's what, these are the beauties I'm going to be driving. That's who's offered me a full-time contract with. I know drivers who have worked for these guys before and speak highly of them. And if you don't know who they are, have a look at them online. However, they have been brought out, or the company I'm actually officially working for is actually EV Cargo, just here. This is the company I'm actually working for, and Downton's are now part of the EV Cargo group. They operate in over 150 countries worldwide. They're a massive, massive general haulage firm, operate all over the world, and they transport from container work to flatbed work to curtain side work, etc. The work I'm going to be doing is going to be in these beauties, general haulage, curtain siders. So that is what I'm going to be doing on night shifts, 4 days on, 4 days off. So there you go, guys. There you go. It's out there. I'm going to be working for Downton's Limited, Downton's Haulage. And like I said, so far, I've had a fantastic experience with these guys so far. The communication with HR and management with EV Cargo has been fantastic. My GM has been brilliant so far. He really has. I say so far, but obviously he's been brilliant. And for me personally, going into the HGV sort of industry as a sort of novice or a newbie, should I say, it's been a pleasant experience for me so far. So I've got no complaints. No complaints whatsoever. And may that continue. May that continue. So, you know, when I work for these guys, and I'm really happy, if there's any newbies out there looking for work, I will always recommend you to these guys. And if they need drivers, of course, you know, why not? You know, so helping each other out as drivers, etc. So, yeah, my first week or 2 weeks, I'm going to be shadowing, or sorry, with another guy on shift, just to make sure that they're happy with me and make sure that I'm confident and competent enough to go out on the road by myself. But I'm really looking forward to that. I'm driving with a guy called Matt, an experienced driver for these for Downton's, and I'm really looking forward to it. Obviously, I'm going to be doing all the driving, of course, which is fine, but I'm learning, and everyone has to start from somewhere. They've given me an opportunity, and I'm really grateful about that. Now, before you say anything, some may say, may have their opinions about what company you work for, etc., etc. We can all do that all day long. But when you become a new driver, one thing I've understood and I've started to notice is that you have to start from somewhere. If a company gives you an opportunity, take it with both hands, because it is all about getting your experience. I'm very lucky to have a company that's given me, that's actually going to have a mentor for me to help me and guide me get started, rather than chuck me straight in the deep end and I have not an idea what I'm doing, I get stuck, etc., etc. So yes, I know being thrown in the deep end is probably the best way to learn, but I'm actually personally quite grateful that I've got a mentor, an experienced driver, just give me a bit of guidance to get started, just to make sure that I know what I'm doing 100%. So everything's a learning curve and I can't wait to get started. So thank you for the opportunity, guys. I'm really, really grateful so far. Should we move on to the equipment? Now you know the news, let's move on to the equipment. Right, equipment. So when you start as a driver, this is the equipment I've got and I'm ready to start with. So firstly, you'll learn this on your training and you'll be asked to get this on your training. Gloves. A decent pair of gloves for when you're doing the coupling and uncoupling vehicle checks on your units or your trailers. If you're doing, you know, trailer swaps, you're doing coupling, uncoupling, etc. It's very important you have a decent pair of gloves. Now, these gloves aren't the best, I must say, since I use these during my training and trying to connect the clip, the dog clip, was a nightmare. So I've always had to take these off. So I wouldn't personally recommend these ones. You want gloves, I think, I've ordered some, but you want some gloves that are actually going to be fitted to the hand so it feels like you've actually got none on. These can be a bit tricky, so just to give you a heads up on that one. But if it means, you know, it's safe and I've got to wear these, then it is what it is. But anyway, gloves, very, very important. The next one is the obvious one, is, yes, a high-vis. High-vis. There you go. Nice and easy. You're going to need a high-vis on your training. You're going to need a high-vis. I have been told that, well, I have got a uniform list for my company that I need to send back to them. They provide me safety boots, high-vis, uniform, etc., etc. But if you can buy your own, obviously, brilliant. If it makes your life easier, buy your own. So, high-vis is what you're going to need as well. And I've been told you're going to need it on most sites that you go to, or every site you go to. Thirdly, if you're working on flatbeds or curtain siders, any sort of load that you've got, you're probably going to be using ratchet straps. So I have decided to buy myself a ratchet winder. A ratchet winder where you can, apparently there's so many out there. I've got this on Amazon. There's so many out there, but this saves you time. If you've got 10, 15, 20 straps and you're in a bit of a rush or you want to get away, this will save you time. You just hook it up and you could just wind it. And as you can see the back there, a quicker way at winding up your ratchet straps as well. So that's one bit of equipment I've got. Price of this, I think it was like £6 or something. I can't remember exactly, but it wasn't expensive. So that's another bit of kit I think every driver is probably gonna need. So I got that. Next, if you're on nights, if it's dark, because we are heading into winter now, and it is getting dark a lot earlier, it is getting lighter a lot later in the morning. So you're probably wondering, what is this? No, it's not a penknife. It is a torch for vehicle checks. So with me doing nights, I'm going to need a decent torch to do vehicle checks. Vehicle checks when I first start my shift, end of day checks when I end my shift, and middle of the shift checks as well. However many times you've got to check it, obviously, you're going to need a torch if you can't see. So I've brought myself a torch. There you go. Pretty bright. Has a number of settings on it. I got this off Amazon as well. This cost me about £18, I think it was, but it's a really good one. And you can adjust the settings on it, etc., etc. So a torch is really important as well. That's that. Next, safety shoes. Now, this is what I'm going to be wearing. They're safety boots, but they're shoes. steel cap safety footwear. They have to be steel cap, guys, when you start in your career. And when you start your training, they're going to recommend have a decent pair of steel cap boots or shoes. These are Dunlop that I've gone for. Dunlop. They cost me about 50 quid, 40 to 50 quid. Not expensive, but I've used them during my training. I'm going to use them during my driving, unless anyone says otherwise. But that is what I'm going to be using, a decent pair of steel cap safety footwear, okay? So that is really, really a must during your training as well. Some people may like these, some people may not. But I've decided to, I was advised to get a trucker's Atlas, because you never know when you might need it. Yes, well, a lot of us use TomToms and sat-navs and stuff now. But you never know when you might need it. So I've decided to buy one anyway. I may never use it, but if I need it as a backup, I've got it to hand. And yeah, obviously being an ex-soldier, I can map read quite well. I think I can anyway. Yeah, I would recommend that. Some people would say, why do you need that? Don't bother. Your Google Maps, etc. But it's a backup. And I'd always rather be safe than sorry. So I've got that as well. Sat-nav. A sat-nav. I've decided to invest into a decent HGV
sat-nav.
I've gone for the TomTom Go Expert. It's you got the screen size. You've got two sizes, 6 inches or 7. I've gone for the 7, the bigger one, only because I've seen other drivers use these. I haven't even opened this yet, guys. I really haven't even opened it yet. But in fact, we can open it now. I haven't even opened it yet, but this was recommended because you can actually put, it tells you at the top of the box, you can actually put all the, it's world maps, you can put all the height restrictions of your vehicle in there, routes. Now, I have been told by other experienced drivers that don't completely rely on these, because they do tend to still take you down some narrow lanes and you can't get yourself out of the situation. So just be very skeptical and very aware and plan your routes accordingly before you start to rely on these too much. But like anything, I guess within experience, you start to learn that. But the great thing about these, everyone uses them. Majority of drivers that I know use them. They highly recommend them. And you can put your height restrictions in there. It's a fantastic bit of kit. I've seen other guys do reviews on these, this bit of kit, and they're really happy with it. And like I said, I've just opened it. I have no idea what they look like inside, but it is something that I'm really excited about using. It is an expensive bit of kit, but it's an investment, I find, an investment long term. It cost me about £369, I think it was, or £369, I think it was. Pounds it's cost me, but it's something I'm going to use during my career. You can update it on a regular basis, and like I said, they do highly recommend it. So yep, that's what I'm going to be using. Let's open it anyway. It's the first time I've actually opened this, guys. It really is the first time I've opened it. So when you open it, it says enjoy the upgrade to better drives. You open it, you've got your book, your guidebook. Your start guidebook. Oh, look at this. This is nice, actually. Whoa, wow. It's massive. You've got your screen. 7-inch screen it is, 7-inch. In HD as well, so it's crystal clear. Yeah, it's quite a big sat-nav. I mean, last time I had a TomTom was many, many years ago when I was in the forces. Not that I use it for the forces, but I had it many, many years ago for my car. And it was nothing like the size of that when they first came out. So that is a huge bit of kit, but it's a good size because you're going to need a decent screen when you're setting everything up, basically planning your routes. What do you get underneath it? It should be a charger, hopefully. Yeah, there you go. So you've got your sticky thing for the window. No idea what it's called, but I know what it's for. USB for charging, of course. And you've got, another charging point as well. That's what USB plugs into, charging point. So that's your equipment for your TomTom. I'm now going to charge it up, and see what this bad boy is like. And I'll hopefully start using it from next week, or will start using it from next week. But I'll let you know. I'll do some more reviews on this, actually, and tell you my experience and what I think of it as time goes on. And we'll see, you know. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. That's pretty much it from me. I just want to keep this as short as possible on equipment. That's what I've actually gone and invested into for my driving career. Like I said, any experienced drivers out there, or anyone who's just started driving or about to start driving, anyone that's training, is there anything I've missed? Is there anything that you recommend that I would need for my driving career? Comment below. Please don't forget to like or dislike, comment and subscribe to my channel. That's it. Subscribe to my channel, because your help and support, your support during my journey has been very great. I've been very grateful for it. I've always been honest every time I do a video. And I hope you're getting some value from my videos. And most importantly, I hope you're enjoying them as well. If there's anything that I've missed, please let me know. But this is based on my personal experience so far. And there'll be a lot more videos coming to you very shortly. So thank you for watching, guys. Be safe on the roads. And I'll speak to you very soon. Bye-bye for now.